Do you want to learn how to move your head in a safely way for Iraqi dance? Stay in this video, because this video is for you.
Hello, I'm Zaida Palma, and as I told you before, I'm gonna teach you how to train your neck for Iraqi and for Kadhi dance. The first thing I want to say is that apart from the cultural facts that I imagine and I hope that you research properly, there are some physical, some technique facts that you need to know not to hurt in order not to hurt your neck. So, Iraqi dance and Kadhi dance, it's become a trendy topic in the Middle Eastern dances, belly dance world, and I've been seeing many dancers, especially from Russia and Eastern Europe countries, many of them that move their necks and their heads very quickly, very fast, and most of them very uncontrolled. So it's not a problem when you are young, but you could cause, if you just imitate those movements without any control, without any awareness of what's going on your neck, it might happen that you sprain your neck, that you can suffer consequences, as the same consequences as when you have a car accident. You don't want that to happen to your neck. So please pay attention and please be under control. I'm gonna teach you in this video a few exercises to develop your strength and your flexibility. And so to make you aware and to make you able to dance actually in a safer way, okay? So two things are the most important things when it comes to protect our neck. First one would be the strength, second one would be the flexibility. Just to make you aware on how important is this, I want you to think that the average weight of the head is 8 kilos, yes. So imagine that you have a bag or you have a 5 liters water bottle in your hand and you start moving those 5 liters suddenly and changing everywhere. So imagine how would your arm feel with that? Well, now be aware that your neck is usually much weaker than your arm, okay? And that you are gonna move without any kind of control your head on a lot of directions. It's not just that you are doing circles or no, it's a crazy thing. It's really very, very important to train your neck. So for the strength, my proposal for you is to work on your muscles, on your neck muscles, without moving your head. So you want to work on the muscles that keep the posture, that keep your neck where it is supposed to be, okay? So you're gonna use your hand as a limit. You are not going to look forward to your hand with your hands. You just put your hand where your head is, and I want you to press against your hand for 10 seconds. Please make sure you keep your shoulder down so you are not on this posture, okay? Your hand is just a witness here. So you push against it, that direction, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, as if you were wanting to do this with your neck. Same thing to the other side. So you put your hand here and go push. 1, 2, make sure this not happen. 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And relax. Feel your muscles, they have to work, okay? Feel what has happened here. Now we're going to work on these two movements. So we have already worked on these basic ones. We're going to work on these ones. So you're gonna put both hands on your forehead and you're gonna push forward, but not forward on this direction, forward, as if you were wanting to look down, okay? And it's important for you to do it with both hands, as it is very important to keep the symmetry in your neck, okay? So both hands here, and you push as if you were wanting to look down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay? You could start feeling already some tension in your neck, or relax, take your time, come back to the neck to the neutral position, come back with it to the neutral position. And now we're going to do the same thing with our hands in the back of our head, like around here. Don't put one hand on top of the other one, you can put them like this or like this. Just try to keep your body as symmetric as you can. Put your hands here and you push back as if you were wanting to look up. You know, move your hands and push. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You could do this sequence of exercises, both sides, front and back, for a couple of times or three times if you want, with some rest in the middle. I suggest you to do it once every other day, and you can combine them with flexibility exercises. I will link, if you're on YouTube, you have to follow the link in the box here to go to my blog, because there you will find, I'm gonna link you, if you're in my blog, you will find the links just below the video. I will link you to my other blog, which is a body awareness and Pilates blog, where you can find some stretching exercises for your neck. But before you go there, let me finish with this, because I have many other things to say to you. The first thing is that you have to keep flexibility. First thing is that flexibility in the neck has to be worked in a very active way. That means that you don't need and you don't want to push your neck to go further. You're gonna keep your shoulders where they are, you're gonna follow the instructions in the other video that I told you, but never push, because you don't want that, you don't need that. You need your muscles to engage, and you need your muscles, your postural muscles, to keep the neck where it is supposed to be whenever you're gonna do this sudden movement. It is also very important that you are aware and you try to notice where is the neutral and the normal posture of your neck. So with a notebook like this one, I love this, is Alice in Wonderland notebook, I'm very fantastic today. That's not the way to say it in English, but Alice in Wonderland and the Neverending Story, Falcon here, whatever. Let's put something that is not too heavy, let's say 200, 300 grams on top of your head. So when you do this, you're gonna notice, if you are aware of it, you're gonna notice that you're gonna push up with your neck. So keep the balance here. You're gonna start feeling your neck engaging, and this going up would be the longest posture of your neck, would be the most approximate to the neutral and the healthiest, I would say, posture for your neck. So whenever you train, make sure you always come back to this neutral posture. Okay, one other thing that happens with this Iraqi Kalingi dance is potential problems in your lower back. I have seen many dancers doing these kind of things, so it's like a going back thing. You do it with your lower back and with the back of your neck. This is potentially harmful. Be careful with it as well. Now, because I know and that you reach this point of the video and I know you are craving for me to explain you how to do the neck movements for Halili, well, let me explain you. Basically, imagine that you have a pen in the top of your head, and you're gonna draw a figure of an infinite sign, like this one, on that diagonal, okay? So it will be this movement, But of course, you're gonna do it faster. It's the same thing as if you draw it on the back diagonal, that would be exactly there. Or there, if I face that way, this will be the posture. We also have this kind of body postures to do these movements. And I've also seen this sudden side to side goes with the neck. So apart from this, I'm not gonna go any further on this movement, but I want you to notice one very, very important thing is that whatever you are doing, also, I forgot about the circles with the head, so this would be this. Apart from this, I want you to notice that every dancer is always using their chest. So I'm not doing circles. For example, let's do a very, very simple example that allows me to speak while I do it. You can notice here that I am using my neck as the end of the movement, as the end of a movement that starts in my abdomen and goes through my chest. Please notice this, don't hurt yourselves. And if you have found this video useful, please thumbs up on YouTube, share it with your friends, with your fellow dancers. We don't want anyone injured. We want everyone dancing till the end of the times. And go to my website, dancepandemic.com, subscribe to my newsletter, because I share things in the emails that you won't find anywhere else. And please, dance happy and move your hair. Thank you. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next video. Work on your muscles.